Hello guys, welcome to Peddi's classroom. This is Pranavi Peddi and in today's video we are going to learn about addition and subtraction of rational numbers. Today's video is little lengthy but there is a lot of useful information. Please watch the whole video and please check out the description box for notes. So guys, let us start our discussion on addition and subtraction of rational numbers. First, we will discuss about addition of rational numbers. In addition of rational numbers is mostly similar to addition of fractions. But in this, we have two cases. First, we'll discuss case 1. Case 1 is when the rational numbers are having same denominator that means for example if I say let me take a rational number a by c and another rational number b by c I need to add these two rational numbers and what one thing we should notice that this rational number is having a denominator c and this rational number is also having a denominator c where a, b, c are integers, that is clear, and c will not be equal to 0. So that is equal to a plus b by c, right? So in this way, if they have the same denominator, we need to do the addition. For example, let me take one example, 5 by 7 plus 8 by 7 is equal to 5 plus 8 by 7, that means 15 by 7. Another example, minus 2 by 8 plus 15 by 8 is equal to minus 2 plus 15 by 8. That means 13 by 8. Minus 2 plus 15, nothing but 15 minus 2. So that means 13 by 8. So this is about the addition of rational numbers if the rational numbers are having same denominator. Now guys, let us discuss case 2, when they are having different denominators. When they are having same denominators, it is very much easy. We can add up the numerators and we can write the denominator common. But when they are having different denominators, we need to follow some steps. There are 4 steps to follow. What is step 1? Write the rational numbers in the standard form. As I have told you, standard form means P. Now, if I take a rational number P by Q, if they are written in the standard form, then P and Q should not have any common divisor. That means they should be co-prime numbers. Okay, they should not have any common divisor other than 1. Then they are said to be in standard form. First, we should write in standard form. Second step, write, find the LCM of the denominators. Now, for example, we have 2 fractions. Let me say A by B and C by D. Okay. Then, these 2 fractions are having some denominators B and D. We have to find the LCM of the B and D. Now, third, express each rational number with common denominator, which is the LCM of the denominators. That means, in the previous video, I have solved the greater and the lesser rational numbers. I have found out the relation between 2 rational numbers, whether one is greater than other or whether one is less than other or they are equal. In that time, I have made A by B in the form of the denominator LCM and C by D also in the form of denominator LCM. So that is third step. I hope if I say you like this, you don't understand. But I will surely give you an example problem to understand. And fourth step is now add them as in case 1. They will have the common denominators. Now we can add them as in case 1. So this is about the case 2. Now, before I written in the form of steps. In the form of steps, it is difficult to explain and it is also difficult to understand. But if we do a problem, that will be very clear. Now, here it is given add 16 by 9, minus 5 by 12, minus 7 by 18. Clearly, these are rational numbers because fractions will be positive as I have already told you. Now, let us start adding them. For adding them, they should have same denominator. To make them have same denominator, first of all, we have to find the LCM of the given denominators. So, LCM of 9, 12, 18. is what? And actually we forgot this step one, that is all should be in standard form. Already they given in the standard form itself, if you can check. And now we have to find LCM of 9, 12 and 18. See here, 9, 12, 18. By 3 tables, 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12, 3 6s are 18. Again by 3 tables, 3 1s are 3 and not possible 4. So 4 we can write down same, and 3 2s are 6. Now 2 table, 1, 2, 1. So now what is the LCM? LCM is equal to 3 into 3 into 2 into 2. That means 9 into 4. That means 36. So our common denominator is 36. Now 16 by 9 plus minus 5 by 12 plus minus 7 by 18. Here we have completed two steps. That is finding whether they are in standard form or not and finding the LCM. What the LCM we got? LCM is equal to 36. Now we have to convert each of these rational numbers into the denominator 36. That means 16 by 9, first let me take. 9, if I multiply with 4, that gives me 36. So if I multiply the denominator with 4, I should also multiply numerator with 4. So numerator I'm multiplying with 4. That gives me 16 into 4, 64 by 9 into 4, 36. Remember this. Now let us do another one. Minus 5 by 12. 12 I should convert into denominator 36. That means 12 3 is 36. So if I multiply with 3 by 3, minus 15 by 36. Next, minus 7 by 18. 18 2s are 36. So I am multiplying with 2 by 2. Minus 14 by 36. Why we are multiplying with the same number in numerator and denominator? Because if we cancel, that becomes 1 again. So we are not changing the value, we are just converting into a different denominator, that means common denominator. Now let us add up all these. 16 by 9 plus minus 5 by 12 plus minus 7 by 18. Nothing but 16 by 9 means 64 by 36 plus minus 5 by 12 means minus 15 by 36 plus minus 7 by 18 means minus 14 by 36. That is equal to 16 minus 15 minus 14 by 36. That is equal to 64 minus minus 15 minus 14 minus 29 by 36. Here if I take borrow, that means 14. Then here 5 and here 5. So 35 by 36 is my final answer. So sum of all this gives me what? 35 by 36. And this is in standard form, so no need to convert into any other form. This is about addition of rational numbers when they are having different denominators. Guys, now let us talk about subtraction. If A and B are any two rational numbers, then A minus B is nothing but A plus of minus B. How can we write this? Because here plus into minus means minus only. Here again we are getting minus. So that's why A minus B can be written as A plus of minus B. Then no need to learn subtraction directly or separately. We can again add up this, but B we should take a negative rational number. Now example 1 is 5 by 7 minus 19 by 7 we should find out. Now let me consider A as 5 by 7, B as 19 by 7. A minus B nothing but what? A minus B equal to A plus of minus B. Then 5 by 7 minus 19 by 7 nothing but 5 by 7 plus of minus 19 by 7. That means we know A plus A by C, A plus B by C nothing but A plus B by C. So 5 minus 19 by 7. That means minus 14 by 7. That means 7 1s are 7 2s are minus 2. So 5 by 7 minus 19 by 7. Therefore 5 by 7 minus 19 by 7 is equal to minus 2. This is our solution. Now let us solve one more problem. Subtract minus 4 by 7 from 3 by 5. Before problem we done with the same denominator, but here we have different denominators. First of all we have to understand the way of the question. Here subtract minus 4 by 7 from 3 by 5. That means 3 by 5 minus of minus 4 by 7. Here some members will take minus here itself and take plus 4 by 7 here. Here it is minus 4 by 7 and minus 4 by 7 is only getting subtracted. Now, minus into minus nothing but plus. So, I can take 3 by 7 plus 4 by 7. Now, they are having different denominators. So, we should find first LCM. They are in standard form only. LCM of 5, 7 is 35. So, 3 by 5 equal to 3 into 7 by 5 into 7. That means 21 by 35. One fraction we got. Sorry, one rational number. 4 by 7 equal to 4 into 5 by 7 into 5. Because 7 5 is 35. Then 20 by 35. Here we got both of these. Now we should add. So what if we add, what we get? 21 by 35 plus 20 by 35. That means 41 by 35. Therefore, this final result or solution for this answer is 41 by 35. The last but one problem of this video and most important problem is simplify minus 3 by 20 plus minus 5 by 12 plus minus 8 by 15 minus of minus 7 by 30. In this problem, addition and subtraction of rational numbers both are included. So let us solve. First of all, minus 3 by 20 plus minus 5 by 12. Then here, plus into minus, directly I can write minus 5 by 12 only. Here we know, right, plus of minus, that means it is minus only. Already we know, a minus b equal to a plus of minus b. So according to that, I have told this. And now minus 5 by 15 plus into minus, minus 8 by 15. And here minus into minus means plus 7 by 30. This is the simplest form. Means we are simplifying step by step. Now we have to find the LCM. All of these are in standard form only. So we should find LCM of 20, 12, 15 and 30. 20, 12, 15 and 30. First let me take 5 table. 5 4s are 20, 12 is not divisible, 3s are 15, 6 are 30. 3 table. 4 is not divisible, so 4 and 3 4s are 12, 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6. And now 2 table, 2 2s are 4, 2 2s are 4, 1 and 1. So LCM is equal to 5 into 3 into 2 into 2. Okay, that means 15 into 2 into 2, 30 into 2, that means 60. So our LCM is 60. LCM equal to 60. We got this. Now we have to convert every fraction into the denominator of 60. As we have already done some problems, we'll go in a faster way. Minus 3 by 20 means denominator into 3, numerator into 3. So minus 9 by 60 minus 12 5s are 60. So into 5, here also into 5. Minus 25 by 60. I can hear minus 15 4s are 60, 18 here also 4 times. So minus 32 by 60. 32s are 60, 7 2s are 14. So plus 14 by 60. This can be written as this. If I bring this side, 14 by 60 minus, I am taking common for all these. 9 plus 25 plus 32 by 60. That means 14 by 60 minus 9 plus 25, what is the value? 34 and 32. So 66. 66 by 60. That means 14 minus 66 by 60, which is equal to 14 minus 66 means minus of 66 minus 14. That is 52 by 60. Now this is not in the simplest form. We can cancel with the 2 table. So 2 30s are and 2 26 are. That is equal to minus 26 by 30.